We go, folks. Welcome to Seafinal Channel. It's late night. It's like 2 o'clock in the morning. I am wide awake. I did not drink coffee, and I'm just gonna do a little filtering show. This clip right here, I lost 3 days ago. It just disappeared. I think I told you about it. I told Sarah about it. Anyways, what I'm gonna do here is put this together with another piece and give you one complete show for like an hour. Okay? We'll see how it goes. Enjoy the music. God bless. Now, the other day when I showed you this, it was a larger picture, but a lot of lens flares flying around, but I seen this one, and it's had a weird look to it, so just check it out. It could be like a spaceship or something. UFO. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to isolate this one, what looks like a lens flare with the other one, but the other ones are more transparent, so I isolated this one, and I did some special filtering just to isolate it around the circle. It's an amazing tool I got right here. And so what happens is, as I isolated it, you can see how it's a little bit different. It's filtered a little bit different because I could do a circle around and just filter that one area. And you can see the ridges on it, just like the Sun Simulator. You know, the one in Hall, Massachusetts, we've seen. Had that same kind of like indent you see up here on the top left. It has like the engine right there. But just watch as I filter this thing. It's pretty incredible looking. You know, I know AJ over there on Facebook, he's been taking lens flares. You see all the lens flares that are around it? None of them will come out like that one. I've tried to filter them. They don't really have any substance to them. This one has a lot of substance to it, so I just honed in on it, black and white right here. And I'll just take it to the filters. Let's put some music on. Now, people, to get that effect right there, where I just cut through the haze, the clouds, the chemtrails, It's just these filters, you know. You could dehaze it. You see how I'm just moving around, bringing down the exposure, bringing up the brightness. I don't use a lot of saturation. But look at this thing. You can see the ridges. You can see the lines on it, people. It's incredible. So, I guess I'm getting a little bit better. But right here, when you look to the left upper 11 o'clock, see how it has the cut in it? Now, remember Hall. I'll show you a picture of Hall, and you would remember it. This thing, these things drive around like round flying spaceships. And they get, you know, they get turned on with the lasers and all, with the sun simulator. I don't know, see what Jeff P. says about this. Crazy. Well, it was fun making that music. That just about took me away. It was a blend of three different songs. And you could do that with Indian music sometime. Let's see what else I can come up with. You guys can't see some of these UFOs flying around, and it's okay. But you can see these two planets right here, right? Real clear on some of the filters. These are two of the moons. I don't know if they're the moons or if they're the lead object or, you know, what, but your guess is as good as mine. That's why I'm doing the filtering show. You guys can comment, thumbs up, you know, chit-chat on the side room, get prayer. It's interesting doing these filtering shows because you guys see a lot more. And, like, you can clearly see on the right-hand side, those two dark orbs are definitely planets or moons, right? Keep watching. Get yourself a cup of coffee because it's 2:47. Do you know where your Planet X Hunter is? Thank you. Okay, so check this out. We're facing northwest. Palma. You see what time it was? Same time. Sun's going down the same time. About 2200 hours. 10 o'clock at night. Yeah. 1036. Check it out. Now watch. And I thought these were pretty interesting. I caught them at the same time. And I started noticing that the northwest had a sun going down, or even extreme north had a sun going down the same time the east had a sun. Watch. kind of getting now where you could just look at a picture sometimes with these crazy skies. Just pick off UFOs, you know? I'm not even going to circle them. Some of them are so obvious. Keep watching, keep watching. I think we're looking at part of the sun simulator, Fresnel lens. Okay, so all along we've been watching northwest, and this is the 29th. We started on the 26th, 27th, 28th, and 29th, so we've been seeing the sun going down north to west, right? Now watch what happens. I think this is the 29th. Northwest, sun's going down. Excuse me, people, excuse me. There you go, east, 29th now. And so it's just the sun reflecting off of it. No. So I'm catching too many of these strange clouds with lights in them. You watch. I'm going to show you a couple of them. So I think there's either one or two small stellar cores right there. Now here's the next, I think it's 10 minutes later, yeah. and 620, so... This one's like 830 on the 29th. See the same thing. Pinto facing east. Crazy clouds on the left covering. Dark blue. So if you see people, I just do that dehazing thing. I just have a preset for a dehazer for the same for every picture. What it does, it pulls back a lot of the chemtrails. That's insane looking though, right? There's a little bit of yellow on the pointer. See it. There's light sources coming. It almost looks like it's underwater on the left side. There's some kind of a cloud UFO looking thing. I'll circle it.